I really want to get to Detroit because I want to make time for what's happening with these kids in Detroit. This is another huge education headline. A judge just missed this case. This was a case that was actually brought on by the students themselves suing educational officials in Michigan, saying that they were denied access to a quality education. And they pointed to, you know, the schools, the overcrowded classrooms, lack of textbooks, you know, black mold, rodents, didn't have pins. There was even, I think, one eighth grade student who said he had to teach seventh and eighth grade math for a month because they couldn't find a teacher. So last year, the state moved for dismissal, arguing the 14th Amendment contains no reference to literacy. Mm-hmm. And then last week, the U.S. District judge agreed with the state on that.
Horrible ruling. Horrible ruling that should be appealed, because the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment doesn't talk specifically about literacy, but it says states cannot deny equal access and opportunity to education. And what this judge is saying, yeah, literacy is very important. It's a 40-page ruling. He acknowledges the importance of literacy.
But then it's not up to the state to make sure kids are literate?
Exactly. That's so long as the schools run. And that's the question here. You've got a warehouse that's chaotic, that's filled with roaches, you know, extreme temperatures, no books, no teachers. How is this a school? You can call it a school, but it's not.
What he did in this decision was he essentially made this a matter of functioning, as you described it, versus existing. And all he's saying is that the school basically just need to turn it on. How it works, or whether it works, or how effectively it works, is not up to the state, which is really problematic.
So if the states, hang on, because I had to read this thing through to try to understand. If it's not up to the states to make sure kids are literate, if they're in public schools, then whose job is it?
It is up to the states, but he's saying they've done their job. They provided schools.
But they're clearly not doing their job.
They're clearly not. They clearly don't have equal access to education, because these are the schools in low-income black neighborhoods.
And to that point, we cannot ignore the racial element to this story.
Absolutely.
And to this decision. DPS, Detroit Public Schools, right now has a population of over 80% black students. 20% of their overall student population is on IEP, individual education programs, which means that requires them to have a little bit more assistance, whether they have behavioral issues or whether they have academic learning challenges. This population that is being marginalized in this direction, in this way, by this decision, this is not by accident. This is intentional. If this were the other way around, if DPS had 83% of white students and that were underperforming in the manner that has been described by these plaintiffs in this case, you better believe that Secretary of Education DeVos would be on a private plane to land in Detroit and figure out what was going on. So when you talk about this decision, you can't ignore the racial element and its impact on what's going on.
So just quickly, what happens to the kids?
These kids, they can appeal this ruling, and I think they should, to a higher court. This was a, you know, U.S. district court, so they'd have to go to the Court of Appeals, because I think it's a completely erroneous ruling. The judge is going through and explaining the importance of literacy in education, but then he's saying the states have done their job.
And looking down the line really quickly, Brooke, from a political perspective, this actually plays into what this administration wants to do in terms of pushing the notion of school choice, because when public schools fail, the idea is, well, if your school isn't performing, then you as a parent should have the option to put it out. The reality is, though, that choice is a fallacy for so many of the people who are affected by this decision.
Charles Coleman Jr., thank you. Sarah Azari, thank you so much as well.